Hello friends, this video on Powers Part 7 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Hello friends, this video on Powers Part 15 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So I think with this you would have got a fair idea about how to deal with the negative exponents. Now let's see that how do we write very large and very small numbers in standard form. So you have already learned about writing a large number in standard form. So how do we write it? We express the number as a decimal number between 1 and 10 and then multiply it by a power of 10. Let's look at some examples. So this is just the recap. For example, 24,000. So this is not the standard form, because whenever you want to write it in standard form, you have to write it in the form of a decimal number between 1 and 10. So this is far greater than 10. So how do we do that? So right now, this number actually means 24,000.00. That's how it means, right? So your decimal point is actually at the end of the number. So what we want to do, we want to shift the decimal point to such a place such that we get a decimal number between 1 and 10. So where will we shift it? We shift it 1 jump, 2 jump, 3 jump and 4 jump. We shift it here so that it becomes 2.4. And then we multiply it by a power of 10. So how much power of 10? So how many jumps have you taken here? So the point was here and then 1, 2, 3, 4. So total 4 jumps you have taken. So it will be 10 to the power 4. So this is the standard form of this number. 2.4 into 10 to the power 4. Let's look at one more example. Let's say you have this. So you have 12 lakhs. So where is your decimal point? The decimal point is here. So we want to shift this decimal point somewhere such that you get a decimal number between 1 and 10. So obviously you'll shift the decimal number here so that you get 1.2 and then you multiply it to a power of 10. What would be the power? The power would be equal to the number of jumps that you have taken. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this would be 1.2 into 10 to the power 6. So in a similar way, when we want to represent small numbers in standard form, there also the logic would remain the same. That is, we would still want to represent that number as a decimal number between 1 and 10 and then multiply it by a negative power of 10. So that is the only difference, that this time you will have a negative power of 10. Let's take an example and understand. So let's suppose you have this number 0.0000021. So how do you write this? So here your decimal point is currently here. So how many jumps you need to make so that you are able to form a number which lies between 1 and 10? So obviously for that you should bring the decimal point here so that it becomes 2.1 and then multiplied by a negative power of 10. And what would be that negative power? That will be determined by the number of jumps that you have taken. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this would be 10 to the power minus 6. So this is the standard form for this small number. So the simple tip is that move right by n jumps. So the value of n in this case was 6. And then the exponent of 10 would be minus n, that is minus 6. So you just need to count the number of jumps. Let's take one more example. So this is another example. So your decimal point is here. So from where, so till where do you want to move the decimal point? So do you want to place it here 5.64? Yes, 5.64 lies between 1 and 10. Would you like to place it here 56.4? So that is far way greater than 10. So that's not the right option. So we will make it 5.64. And how many jumps have you taken? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this would be minus 7. So 5.64 into 10 to the power minus 7. So see, with this, you must be able to understand that how do we represent very, very small numbers in standard form and how the negative exponents help us in representing very small numbers. Now let us look at these realistic examples where we actually need these values. So if I ask you the mass of the earth, the entire planet earth, so obviously the mass is huge as you can see on the screen. So if I actually ask you mass of the earth, it will take you good amount of time to calculate the number of zeros first and then find out their positions, right? So what do we do? Instead of doing that, we represent it in a simpler way. So let's see. In this case, instead of writing this, what we do is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So you basically have some 21 zeros after 5, 9, 7, 2. So instead of writing this, we denote it or we write it in its standard form. So right now the zero is here, so we have to take the zero all through these places and finally we need to make it reach a place such that we get a decimal number between 1 and 10. So do you think if we place the decimal point here, you will get a decimal number between 1 and 10? No, because 5972 is greater than 10. What if we place it here? We will get 597.2. That also doesn't lie between 1 and 10. Here, no. Here, 5.972. Yes, this would work out. So this becomes 5.972 into 10 to the power. How many jumps? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So this would be 10 to the power 24 kgs. So instead of writing so many zeros, you can just say 5.972 into 10 to the power 24 kgs. That's the mass of the earth. So it was very simple. We just moved left by n jumps and then added n to the existing exponent of 10. So here the value of n was 24. Let's take another example where we are trying to find something which is very, very small. For example, the size of a plant cell. Now, as we all know, all living organisms, they are finely made up of cells. Cells are the building blocks of living organisms. So when you look at a plant cell, which is extremely microscopic, so its size is around this 0.0000125 meters. So how can we represent this in standard form? So your decimal point is here. So we start moving towards right. That is, we start moving the decimal point towards right until it reaches a position where you get a decimal number between 1 and 10. So that decimal number is 1.275. So this can be written as 1.275 into 10 to the power minus how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 10 to the power minus 5 meters. Now, in this fashion, we can even compare very large numbers with very small numbers. For example, if you try to compare the size of the earth with the size of a plant cell. So how would you compare that? So we know that diameter of the earth is in this range, 1.2756 to the power into 10 to the power 7 meters, whereas diameter of a plant cell is of the order of 1.275 into 10 to the power minus 5 meters. So let's denote this by diameter of the earth, DE. That's denoted by diameter of the plant cell, which is DP. So the ratio of the earth's diameter to the plant cell's diameter would be equal to 1.2756 into 10 to the power 7 divided by 1.275 into 10 to the power minus 5. So if you compare this part, just leave this part aside. So this is approximately equal to 1. So 1 multiplied by 10 to the power 7 by 10 to the power minus 5. So same base, different exponents, division. So your exponents will get subtracted. So this becomes equal to 10 to the power 12. So that means the mass, the size of a cell, of the plant cell, is very, very small than that of the size of the earth. Or we can say size of the earth is 10 to the power 12 times the size of a plant cell. Thank you. Questions. Question number one, express the following numbers in standard form. So here you have a big number. So where is your decimal point right now? It's here. So we need to shift this decimal point all through these places to reach that point where you get a decimal number less than 10. So we have to shift it somewhere here so that it becomes 6.02 into 10 to the power. How many jumps? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So this is 10 to the power 15. So 6.02 into 10 to the power 15. Let's look at the next one. Here your decimal point is here and you will move towards the right. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this becomes 8.37 into 10 to the power minus 9. So another way of remembering when to put positive exponent and when to put negative exponent is, for negative exponent you would see that you always make jumps towards the right. For positive exponent you always make jumps towards the left. Question number 2. Express the following numbers in usual form. So the numbers are given in their standard form and you have to write it in their usual form. So 3 into 10 to the power minus 8. So since you have, first you write 3. Now since you have minus 8, what does that mean? That means, so whenever we get minus 8, we tend to, whenever we write negative exponents, we tend to move towards right. Right, while writing the standard form. So this time, since minus 8 is already given, that means the decimal point was somewhere this side. Because only when the decimal point was this side, you would be making jumps towards the right. Correct? But it is 10 to the power minus 8. So that means you must have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 zeros after the decimal point. So that, how many jumps will you take? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, because you have written it as 3 into 10 to the power minus 8. So that means this would be the usual form, 0.00000003. Let's look at the next one. So here you have a positive exponent. First you write the number, which is 361492. Then how many, what is the power on 10? It is 10 to the power 6. So what you do, you put those many zeros. That is, you put 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Perfect. So this time you have put zeros after the number because it is positive exponent. So whenever it is a positive exponent, add zeros after the number. When it is a negative exponent, add zeros before the number. So negative exponent, what you do, add zeros in fact before the number. In this case, add zeros after the number. So you have added so many zeros. Now where would be the decimal point located? So look at this. Here the decimal point is, after the decimal point, how many digits do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So count 5 digits from this, from the end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the decimal point would be located here. So therefore your answer would be 3614920. So whenever you have positive exponent, add zeros after the number. You have negative exponent, add zeros before the number. Question number 3. Express the number appearing in the following statements in standard form. Charge of an electron is this many coulomb. So how will you express this in standard form? So for standard form, you want the decimal point to be present here. So you need to shift the decimal point from here to here. So it would be 1.6 into 10 to the power minus. How many jumps will that need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. So this would be 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Second one is, size of a bacteria is 0.0000005. So for this, in standard form, what is the number that you would need here such that the number lies between 1 and 10? So that number would be 5. So you want the decimal point to be here so that it becomes 5 into 10 to the power minus how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this would be 5 into 10 to the power minus 7 meters. Now please remember that if you write it like this, 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 6, even though this value is equal to this, but this is not the standard form. Why? That's because 0.5 doesn't lie between 1 and 10. Question number 4. In a stack, there are 5 books each of thickness 20 mm and 5 paper sheets each of thickness 0.016 mm. What is the total thickness of the stack? So the total thickness of the stack would be equal to total thickness of the books plus total thickness of the sheets. So let us first calculate total thickness of the books. So how many books do we have? We have 5 books and thickness of each book is 20 mm. So 5 into 20 is 100. So 100 mm is the total thickness of the books. Now let us calculate total thickness of the sheets, the paper sheets. Now each paper sheet thickness is 0.016. So this multiplied by 5, which gives you 0.080 mm. So this is the total thickness of the sheets. Therefore, let us find out the total thickness of the stack. So total thickness of stack would be 100 plus 0.080 mm. So this is equal to 100.08 mm. Now, if I ask you to write it in standard form, how will you write it in standard form? For standard form, decimal point must be located after such a number so that you get a decimal number between 1 and 10. So you need to shift the decimal point to this place so that you get 1.008, which is a number between 1 and 10. And 10 to the power how much? Because this time you are moving towards the left. So whenever you are jumping towards the left, then the exponent is always positive. And here you have made 2 jumps, so it would be 10 to the power 2. So this is 1.008 into 10 to the power 2. So please remember this simple thing. Whenever you are jumping towards the left, that is, you are making the decimal point jump towards the left, your exponent is going to be positive. Whenever you are making your decimal point jump towards the right, your exponent is going to be negative. So with this, we have reached towards the end of this lesson, and I hope that this lesson on powers would have helped you. So try to solve more problems and see if you have any further questions. You can definitely post them on the Ask Question section of examfear.com. See you all in the next lesson.